Velvet Hero.
Yeah,
very well executed the Asmode comp. There were little flaws, if any, outside of the early game.
Absolutely.
So I'm definitely looking at that and thinking maybe that should be a second ban on the Asmodan.
Yeah, I agree. And especially here in such an, I would call it, less professional atmosphere. You can't compare it to the highest level, the highest echelons of competitive play. Players can be target banned a lot more easily because their player or their hero pool, excuse me, may not be as high as you would expect from a true professional.
So, what do you think potentially either of the teams would need to change to either if Italy to stay on top or Finland to potentially come back? Like you said, maybe the Asmodan ban, but what else could be done?
I think Finland picked a comp that was hard to execute. It's not easy to run Task Tracer at a high level, especially when you pick it so early that the enemy team can draft around it. So I'd like to see them resort to an easier comp, but again, the same style. We saw how it worked from the early game. We saw some of the mid games where they had these fantastic turnarounds. Stick to the same style, clean it up a bit, play something a bit more comfortable.
And we're about to enter a comfort zone for most teams here because we're going to see a very popular battleground. We're going to see Infernal Shrines being picked as the next map. Right. And I think there's no more excuses here, really, for Finland to maybe just blame it on the map. You know, Volskaya Foundry is a little bit wonky. We weren't really sure how to play there. No, this is a battleground that has been in the competitive scene for a long time. So standard strategy may help them out to just outclass Italy.
Worst Asmodan map. It's doable. You can definitely do it on here if you rotate between just two of the lanes.
Yeah.
So we will see if Finland is able to react to that. But we also see a couple other heroes who can gain huge priority on this map that we might not have seen on Volskaya. For example, Abatha could jump up a little bit in priority just due to soaking potential. More AoE here. Sonya's going to stay way up in terms of priority.
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
Yeah, and then there's, of course, Infernal Shrine's pockets picks like Kerrigan, for example, which may pop in here and there at Diablo, you know, knock people against the walls near the shrine zones. There's a lot of cool picks that we could potentially see in this second draft of this best of three between Italy and Finland. Let's go. So, that looks like we still need a little bit of time. No problem. We can fill in a little bit more. Italy, what surprised you the most when you saw their play in game number one?
I didn't expect it. Their stacking was not perfect. They missed a couple minions, but the fact that they were able to not lose as much as before, this could be down to the fact that, like we said, Tracer isn't the best pusher with the comp they had, but they did try a three-man push, and Rhaegar was able to hold it, and when he started to get out of his comfort zone, when he was starting to get pushed too hard, they brought up ETC, and they were able to protect everyone enough so Asmodan was able to stack without too much of these difficulties.
Now, Bakery, I want to ask you this. Finland's got Telwyn, Varian main. Pick it, yay or nay. Is it time?
Oh, I'm not sure it's time yet. So the big thing about this matchup is this could be the decider between who places second and who places third and who actually makes it to the playoffs. So this is a very important match for Finland. It might be the time for Varian, but personally, I'd like to see him hold off a bit more.
Okay, I can feel you.
Stick to the standard stuff. It was working well, or was it working very well at times last game. It's just that final, I'd say, 10% of their play needed to be cleaned up.
Right. Tix, putting him on a hard carry or hyper carry like Tracer, is that the right way to go? Do you think they should try that again?
I do believe they should try that again. Maybe not quite as much as Tracer. And Greymane, I think, definitely a hero that can work as well. Greymane, a very high mechanical skill cap hero, something that Tix, I'd imagine, would be very comfortable with. And taking away the ETC, which Italy had so much success with last game.
Genji would have also been an amazing hero to put Tix onto, so it shows Italy done their research. Very solid ban coming in by them. So
absolutely.
Moving that. Whereas Finland, removing the Tassadar shows that it would have been cool with the Greymane, but it's clear they don't want to face that kind of double combo, which could get that huge protection aspect when they have some with the burst potential of Greymane.
Now, keep in mind that players were chosen by Blizzard and they were invited by Blizzard onto this tournament according to their Hero League performance, how their MMR worked in general. Now, highlighting some of the contrast here between Hero League casual play and pro play, Garrosh dominates Hero League drafts left, right, and center. Do you think he's going to play a role here in this tournament as we move on?
Garrosh is a very tricky hero because his power comes from that very impressive combo that he has where he pulls someone in, he flips them over, and in Hero League, that's it. That's the damn deal. In match-made play, that's brutal, but when you have comms and you are playing competitively with a team, it gets much easier to deal with that, and it gets much easier to say, let's drop a cooldown on them, let's keep fighting, let's not let anyone get comboed for free, and let's actually just move in. And Garrosh really does struggle to find a role in competitive play. So I don't think either team will be putting it out high priority. And since it does have to be a main warrior, when both teams already have Sonya, Arthas, and ETC, I think that's pretty much locked out of this draft.
All right, and we see a pretty beefy front line coming in for Team Italy already. So the Sonya and the Arthas, once again, strong shrine control, a lot of self-healing, so the support gets relieved a little bit.
Crazy AoE damage as well. We've got, of course, the Frozen Waste, the Rhaegar's Lightning Shield, and Sonya's Whirlwind. They are going to be able to clear that up very quickly, and that's before they even pick their assassin.
What about globals here in Infernal Shrines Bakery? No Dehaka, not no bribing so far. Oh, there we go.
Gotcha. Globals are important on Infernal Shrines if you want to play a certain way. There are two main styles in Infernal Shrines. You can play, let's fight over the shrine, or you can play, let's not fight at all and just run away and push towers, global, stuff like that. So the fact that Finland just banned Brightwing indicates to me they might be looking to pick up possibly a Dehaka, possibly another main tank, and have ETC be their global with Stage Dive.
True. Yeah, that's a very good point. If you have a main tank at ETC site, you can always opt into that Stage Dive.
Yeah, Greymane also works very well with Stage Dive. It works well with most things, but Stage Dive great for preventing that escape potential from a distance. So it can seriously help out, gives you that crazy engage potential. So we'll be interested to see how they react with that. And they do still need a support. Uther's still open. He's played a role already in today's matches. And MXD, relatively solid performance.
I think the big question for Finland here is, do we opt for the double support? So there's a lot of benefits to double support. It makes your shrine a lot stronger. But at the same time, when you have Greymane ETC, your macro game could be so strong if you end up picking a solo support like the Uther or like Karazim. Going for Gul'dan, which is a fantastic hero on shrine, and we do see the main tank, which does most likely mean stays there with ETC. I really like the direction.
Cool. Yeah, and a good sanctification with a Greymane is just one of the most legendary combos we have in this game. With Uther still open as well, they can go for double invulnerable Greymane if they want to. And that's going to put whatever backline Italy pick under serious pressure.
So the Gul'dan pick here is most likely going to force Italy into picking a second support. Rhaegar alone has a very tough time dealing with Gul'dan for two main reasons. Gul'dan's poke is one of the highest in the game, and Rhaegar just does not have the healing to keep up with it in an elongated fight over the shrine. But also, Gul'dan's horror fight, it's so brutal against Rhaegar because he needs to be melee ranged to get effectiveness. Yeah. So picking a second support, definitely something I'd like to see from Italy, and really doubling down that Sonya and trying to make something work there.
And positioning is something you brought up here against that fear, horrify play. Do you think they're going to have to go for a ranged support then? Because if they went Uther, for example, they could possibly get hit both.
Well, they've gone for Stukov, so...
His healing is ranged.
He's half and half. Maybe he'll take the level 1 talent and become a true ranged hero.
Maybe. That actually would not be too bad of an idea here. Keep himself heavy on the micro and a little bit of slow potential. Tied a little bit to add onto Greymane, make him a little bit hard. Make it a little bit harder for him to chase down the Rhaegar or the Lunara, for example. Whereas Finland, they still need their support. Uther's still available, like we said, if they want to go for like a hyper chase potential. Solo Lucio, not as popular as it used to be in the past, but it's there, it's an option.
I think Lucio is the hero that I would pick in Finland's situation. Lunara was a very smart pick that basically pigeonholed Finland into, okay, do Uther's we pick a solo Uther and end up with very low sustain? Or do we pick the Lucio? There we go.
There we go, I like it. But as you said, Bakery, the poke damage provided by Lunara shuts down a certain style of support, which Uther falls into that category, Aurel falls into that category, she struggles against AoE poke a lot as well. So really smart play draft-wise also by Team Italy.
Yeah, this is why we actually saw them likely pick the Stukov. For starters, it's a little bit of extra protection AoE against the Gul'dan, but it would have been a perfect hero. If Lucio was outside of Lucio and Uther, Stukov would have been perfect because he's big, chunky AoE healing, so he's burst protection against the Sonya, and he's also overtime healing protection against the Lunara. He would have been perfect, so stealing him away, brilliant play by Italy.
Yeah, absolutely. So one of the keys to the game that I had written down before this series started was that Italy favors chaos. Mm-hmm. As a Hero League team, I'm playing against a team that wants to have a very structured, very mapped out game plan. You want to play chaos and you want to just let everything shine. We saw it in game one with the Asmodan, and now with the off-meta Lunara forcing certain weird picks into Finland, I think we're going to see the same thing. I'm personally feeling really good about Italy's play.
Yeah, so building up on that, Bakery, do you think Italy's draft is strong enough to also dominate and maybe even win game two?
I don't think their draft is objectively stronger, but I think they have the right style. They showed already how good a team they were in game one and coming back from the early game deficit even. So I believe Italy is in a great position to take the series. But at the same time, we cannot count Finland out. They have a much more standard draft. They drafted very intelligently, denying globals from the enemy team while picking ones themselves, having a very good dive setup with Horrify, Sanctification, yeah. Greymane. It's in anyone's hands.
It really is. And Tetra, we're going to find out who's going to take home game number two. Is it going to be Italy? And are they going to get that first victory under their belt? We're going to find out soon when we go to Infernal Shrines. That's going to be our battleground.
Yes, we are. And ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Infernal Shrines on the left. Currently 1-0 up in the series. It is going to be Team Italy.
And their opponents this time, once again in the red trunks, it is Team Finland. And Tetra, those guys were hyped a little bit pre-draft or pre-series by our analysts and by our commentators. So they are going to have to live up to their name. They're going to have to really make players like Tix shine if they want to take this home. Italy, on the other hand, they can approach this a little bit more, you know, comfortably. They can be like, okay, guys, let's slow down. We already got game one under our belt. We don't have to go all in necessarily.
Exactly. They can have a much easier time here if they are just a little bit more patient. So, let's see if they can do so. This time, Tix being on that Greymane.
Yep.
Less chance of exploding, more chance of doing the exploding. making explosions happen.
Sounds good to me. Greymane is just such a wonderful hero. He's incredibly versatile. You can play him as a long-range poker. You can go as a very explosive melee assassin. It's just, I think it's safe to say that there's no other hero in the game as versatile, as flexible as Greymane in the assassin department.
I would almost certainly agree. I'm also speaking of flexibility, though. We currently have in the top lane on that Sonya. Guess who it is? It's going to be Rayquaza, the person who played just such a spectacular Malfurion in the last game. Main support, basically one of the two supports into that crazy melee damage dealer, or the melee mage, as we sometimes call it.
I thought you were going to go to Stukov's arm, speaking about flexible things, you know. So Moldavius on that hero is definitely going to have to play an important role here as well, especially when the first shrines are opening. I think you can really use the lurking arm to completely zone out the enemy team and force them to approach from a different angle.
Indeed, and when you can force someone to approach from the angle you want, when you have Arthas on your team, you are going to have a wonderful time. You can choose where they engage from. You can make Greymane's job completely miserable because Greymane can't jump in. Normally, he would just try and jump past the front line into the back line. This time, not available though, not an option.
And a lot of responsibility, of course, also lies on the shoulders of Tyrael. Tyrael is such a playmaking hero. If you miss the timing Orpheus Sanctification, if you don't have clean mechanical execution, you can really look like a goof. Whereas if you land all those abilities, you're like a god on the battlefield.
Yes, you are. So we are starting off with a little bit of auto attack based talents, the focused attacks coming in from Sonya, and the lock talent to try and counteract a little bit of that Greymane. Nice route by Arthas. Good
lurking arm.
Following up, EGC. It looked like they were just fine, but now serious danger having to drop that face melt with the extra radius of the loud speakers. So he is able to escape, but that was far more dangerous than we expected it to at the start of that engage.
I think Rayquaza on the Sonya was, for a very short moment, thinking of maybe tunnel visioning like in Hero League and chase that ETC down no matter what. But good thing he didn't commit to it and saved his life potentially, because there was a nearby enemy fort. Now we see a good lockdown, a nice spirit, followed by the lurking arm, immediately takes in trouble, and Lucio says goodbye first blood for Team Italy.
Team Italy really, really showing up today. Lucio poking away at Team Italy, doing what he can, but he's just a poor little Lucio. He does not do the most damage.
No.
As such, all you can really do is poke down here. He's now rotated around to be part of this defense. Tyrael should be able to dodge this if he times it correctly.
Yeah.
Nicely done. So that was a really nicely performed pull. So this will make clearing this up a lot easier, but they will still forfeit at minimum two towers.
Yeah, and look at the XP, Tetra. Team Italy is already skyrocketing away here compared to their opponents, compared to Finland. They were making sure to have someone soaking on the side lanes, top and bottom in time. They did not lose any unnecessary XP there. And already, they're not really overcommitting with this first Punisher push either, because similar to Volskaya Foundry, map objectives, they scale over time. So the first ones may not be super strong, but the last ones, the later ones, that's the ones that really matter.
So something that is worth mentioning is Stukov didn't actually go for the extra range here. He instead went for something that is still technically extra range. Went for the growing infestation, the growing radius of his lurking arm. level 4, just healing. One good spread, reducing the returning of a little bit of mana and reducing the cooldown of his healing power by 2 seconds if he hits 2 heroes. Not too difficult when you have a Rhaegar and Arthas of Estonia who are likely going to be fairly grouped. The Rhaegar, however, might be in trouble. Fisty Fish, beautiful face belt. Even the
invaders
are helping now. And down he goes. That was close, actually.
That was very well.
Oh, God. Lucio
no way.
With a speed boost, just pulling Tyrael out of range of that poison spore by Cester.
The speed boost was what saved Tailwind's life there on the Tyrael. Oftentimes, Lucio players will have that instinct of keep on healing to save somebody, but Lucio's heals are so limited, they're so minimal, that the speed boost is oftentimes, or almost always, able to soak up and prevent more damage than the healing ever could.
Yeah, it's better if your teammate has just a little bit of health left to get them out of danger first before you heal the damage they've already taken, because you don't heal that much over a short period of time. You need that longer period of time to start getting that healing value.
Especially when there's a lot of damage available and a lot of CC available, slowing effects available, provided by Arthas, by the slowing totem from Rhaegar, etc. Even Lunara could apply a little bit of a slow herself. Now, the second Shrine phase is about to get activated. It's going to be a Frozen Punisher. So very important for Finland not to give in that easily, but looks like they're not even trying. Look at all the positioning here on the minimap. We see Tyrael, ETC in the middle, Greymane with a strong push, even reinforced by a Mercenary camp. He's going to be able to inflict a lot of damage.
He is indeed. He's committed to that push here, trying to race him towards level 10, because they are ahead in XP. It's even on kills.
Yeah.
So they are right now just trying to delay. We can see Sonya has actually just ditched this objective and has moved up
exactly.
Top lane to prevent the push. But is it still an objective going over to Italy? The question is, how well can Finland defend this? If they can defend this well, they've actually come out quite nicely here with that big XP boost.
It's a very close race.
I think Sonya may be attempting to kill Greymane up there. ATC's up there too. Having a bit of a duel. Sonya's dropping down up in the top lane. Can they finish her?
She survives for now. The cocktail is not enough. Yeah, that's a huge deal, actually. Them not getting the kill means they're going to take a lot of damage in the middle lane. Look at Lucio. Look at Gul'dan already dropping so low. Fatal arrow.
Sonya's still running away, by the way. Can we jump to the mid lane quickly, Observer? Because that's still happening. Sonya's run all the way down here.
The ultimate survivor.
Continues to push the bot lane. They brought friends. They brought reinforcements.
Oh, the double mosh pit.
Rhaegar, do the damage. Sorry, Greymane. Greymane has to retreat here.
Save
by Rhaegar there, actually, dropping the healing onto Rayquaza. That fight has been happening since top lane.
That was crazy.
For the Punisher. Punisher is still going. They were able to take down the fort, thanks to that lovely distraction. Sonya occupying two members of Finland and surviving. Beautifully done. Massive shove, I've just noticed, coming in for the Stukon.
Yeah, normally Zarya claims to be the strongest woman in the world, but Sonya, after that escape, can certainly claim that title too. Beautifully done. I think Rhaegar actually came in time to drop the Ancestral Healing as well. It was on a 90-second cooldown when we last looked.
He saved us.
Yeah, he really used it all.
Done. And Finland, though, they're not as far behind as they have been in the previous game, but this time they are, once again, holding their XP lead, and this time they don't have to worry about Asmoblar. This time it's really about Sonya engaged. Instead, we're just going to see a quick split push happening here. Once again, similar to last game, Finland will take bot fort and Italy will take top fort. There is very little that either team can do about this, except the difference is Italy are also soaking mid. Rhaegar is chilling in that lane.
They're trading blow for blow here. Both teams getting a fort respectively in the bottom and in the top lane. The thing is, though, in favor of Team Italy, they still have that Bruiser camp pushing. You can see the Shaman here really building up a lot of additional pressure, and they will have to use Klefter on the Gul'dan to really get rid of it. That buys a little bit of time here for Team Italy to establish a strong map position. As you can see, they're trying to get more mercenary camps. It wouldn't surprise me if they also try to contest the bottom Impaler camp here.
They also got value from Rhaegar. Like we said, he was soaking mid. He actually pushed up and dropped a fair amount of health on that mid four. Just little bits of value here and there being taken by Team Italy.
Now Team Italy needs to be careful. There's still a fort standing in the top lane, so Finland is already posturing up to get another chunk of XP under their belt. And in the bottom lane, there isn't really a lot left standing for Finland, so Italy is not likely going to get value out of this. But nonetheless, level 13 is around the corner here for the Italians, and what are they going to pick here? Earth Shield for Rhaegar, very solid, especially when used on heroes like Sonya or Arthas.
Giant Killer coming in for that Lunara, going to be very useful at trying to burn down that ETC. Stukov, he is bringing out the Lingering Spy.
Yeah.
The mostly, I would argue, the standard version from this talent tier.
Especially if you go that lurking arm route.
Yeah. We do sometimes get a little bit of reactive ballista pause. Once again, that's not usually in the lurking arm route. That's if you are potentially about to get burst by many people. Just get a little bit of value in the meantime. So, Italy, once again, seizing the objective, and Finland not looking to contest it. Instead, they're just going to bring out a mercenary camp. Actually, no, they're ditching the mercenary camp. What are they doing? Looks like they are going to contest.
Yeah, I think they're going to contest after all. Level 13 is here now, of course, but already 33 skeletons destroyed on the side of Italy. Booya has to use the Army of the Dead, needs to stay alive at all costs. Otherwise,
good, horrifying.
Oh, that was a good, good disengage.
Yeah, but they didn't get anything out of that. They've lost the objective and burned a big defensive cooldown here. So in comes the Punisher. In the meantime, there's still an Impaler camp which get the bot lane. They didn't get their mercenary camp. That was just a absolute cavalcade of disaster coming in by Finland.
Yeah, double prong attack now coming in for Italy. They will have a massive Arcane Punisher, the most threatening of them all when it comes to tearing down structures. And as Tetra said, there's also an Impaler camp still distracting Finland in the bottom lane. The bait over the wall, this time not successful. It was silenced as well by Stuka. Very well done. And there's only so much Finland can do. Heavy, heavy damage being dealt onto that outer tower line.
That Zodic silence is such a big deal, considering it was good for some reason called Dan that went to the bot lane. Who defend? Nice move by the Arthas there. Ooh. Dropping huge damage onto Felduin. Punisher's dropping down again. The silence.
Look at the silence.
Them just further and further back. And down goes that key. First of the game. Massive shove sent ETC into the backline so that he could not drop that mosh pit. He does still have it off cooldown though, but the potential is still there moving forward. I said I want to try and do something here.
Horrify's not ready.
Yeah, Italy. There is a retreat. Nice
Beautiful.
Group. That's it. That's the retreat.
And we really have to commend Italy here for playing such a nice defensive style. Going for the aggression when the Arcane Punisher was next to them, but knowing when to back off when Finland was trying to land a counter strike.
Yeah, ETC is still wanting it, but once again, Italy playing the retreat game. Yep. Retreat, drop damage abilities, see if they can poke people down. And that's what they need to do. They're just creeping their way towards level 16, getting themselves, like you said, another talent advantage.
Exactly. 16 is around the corner. They were able to collect so much experience by just destroying that top lane altogether. They were like, why should we get initiated on? Why should we give Finland the fight they were wanting to get? When we could just wait a little bit, take a chill pill, and of course get that 16 so we can fight with another massive advantage.
Right now, they are looking really, really solid. You can see here, Finland, they are trying to do something. Wisp? Wisp?
Do it again, Wisp. You can do it.
Wisp.
Oh! I don't think it was in the bush.
I don't know. I don't think it's saw him.
No. So, but something smells fishy here. Lunara knows. There we go.
Wisp came back for a third round. Finally was able to see the entire team. And Sesk, look at it. He moved towards it and then was like, no, I play safe. Mm-hmm. Move the Wisp back up. Lovely play. Just good game sense.
Yeah, I was going to say, that's another indicator of how well the Italian team is communicating with each other. You can really see everyone's on the same page. They have invested countless hours of practicing to really build up that team synergy. So cool to see from the Italian team.
ETC has now, however, finished stacking up his little bit of extra sustain for his team, considering that Lucio, like we said, not the most burst protection. Having that double AoE healing over time is going to be exceptionally useful for him.
And Gul'dan, up to this point, he plays the role of the janitor. He always has to keep the house clean. He's always the one being deployed into their base when the mercenary camp or now catapults in the top lane are pushing.
He actually has to leave now. There's still a catapult in this lane.
Exactly.
He has to move.
And the next Punisher, to be honest, could be another keep. But look what Team Finland is doing. They're sending a three-man unit for a sneaky covered ops mission here in that top lane. They're trying to take down at least the tower lane, but they need to be careful not to get caught. Italy's already on the back.
They've got the towers.
That's good.
Back up.
That's
they're
good.
Mounted. They're good.
Yep.
Dan is defending. They're going to lose an objective, but they're creeping towards 16, which is going to make their defense a lot easier.
And Gul'dan and Best Peon Boys work. Always on mercenary duty here in the middle lane, in the bottom lane. Impalers are knocking on the front door of Finland, left, right, and center. And they're going to have to brace themselves now for a potentially life-saving defense here. If they lose a couple of team members with this Punisher now after almost 14 minutes, I think they could very well lose the game.
They really could. Could Finland be finished? Let's find out if the Punisher moves in to try and end the game, if they can get those picks. ETC completely scouted. Come on. Stukov can just... Oh, hang on. This could be dangerous. Stukov needs to be much more careful. But the slow is good. And now ETC, oh, even Mordendyle, they're just buying time at this point.
So nice.
Greymane is now so far forward. Yep. ETC moving in. They've just dived straight past the Punisher. The Punisher is now out of the equation. It's just a team fight now.
Good. Sound Barrier's good.
They're doing huge damage.
Barrier's
the
good.
Oh my, gets quite a few. Punisher's back in play as they had to retreat back to their base. Klefter dropping low. ETC still with Moshpit. The Sanctification Moshpit getting to the massive shove. Not going too far. Fisky Fish able to keep everyone in the team alive except for Gul'dan, who was dropped down.
Double stun, double silence.
Punisher, Thelduin dropping low, Sonya picks up another kill, and they lose the Greymane, and we are seeing Italy pushing onto the core. They've lost top key, they don't even need the one that the Punisher was pushing. They have tried to end the game. Fisky Fish trying every game to defend, but it's only MXD for the damage. That's nowhere near enough, and that is GG, Kendrick. Italy take game number two and the series.
Italy, Forza Italia, they take another victory. And not just that, Tetcher, they take a very important series here in Group A against a quote-unquote favored team. Finland just didn't show up. Maybe they were still a little bit sleepy. Maybe the synergy hasn't really been built up yet. But we can't really deny the fact that Italy just played one hell of a series. And everybody who had, you know, it win, hashtag it win in the chat, did their math correctly. So
they did.
Very well done.
Very well done. Beautiful play by Italy overall.
Fantastic.
Really not. We were leaning too much on Tix, potentially their bakery.
Absolutely. So Italy, they showed up and they showed why those players were picked. They were absolutely impressive. Cohesive unit. Impressive individual plays as well. The Stukov, especially that game from Moldavius,
yeah.
Who the Asmodan last game as well. He's on fire this series.
Yeah, take a look at some of the unfamiliar faces, because who knows how long they're going to stay unfamiliar, because Moldavius is making a strong cause for himself here. As you said, that wonderful Asmodan in game number one, a beautiful Stukov in game number two. Quite frankly, he was all the difference in some of those team fights.
He really was. And these are the kind of players that I am so excited to see what their future holds for them, whether that is just an open division, whether they're just playing the game for fun. But this is, considering it's the first time, like we said, you guys are potentially seeing some of these players, that's a good first showing. Very well done, Team Italy.
Absolutely. And I think supports play quite the crucial role here in this game, so who better to take us through some replays than Bakery?
Yeah, absolutely. So the first replay we're going to see here is the Greymane pickoff. So as we pause it, we're going to see that as this fight started, Finland were in a fantastic position. They were even on shrine. They were all here. They start moving away, and the patience from Booyah on the Arthas. He waits until they are all stuck in this corridor, and then he roots. And as he roots, then Sonya spears. And as Sonya spears, the silence comes out, and there's absolutely nothing that Finland can do. There is no cleanse. There is no big healing cooldown. And this is where Italy just gain control of the game, and they never give it up. So as we move on to the next replay, as we see Greymane go down, we're going to look at the same thing again. So the root comes out instant onto Greymane, and you can see there's absolutely nothing that Tix can do. And that's Tix. That's the man you need to take down. And they were on point about doing that this whole game. The next replay here, we're going to see the Veigar pickup on the bot lane.
In a bit.
in a second, you know.
So
Veigar's been pushing a bit too far. He was a bit greedy for the wave, but look at how he turns this. He aggroes the easy camp, and then he focuses his efforts on trying to get a turnaround on the Tyrael. And here comes Moldavius on the Stukov. And Tyrael low, but he's going to have just enough mana to queue out as we see him escape as we roll the replay forward. Now level 10. Now this was a really cool moment. So Finland themselves were looking for a pickoff.
Yeah.
On the Sonya, Veigar,
really
fantastic heads-up play, comes from the bot lane where they are pushing with the Punisher, gets the Ancestral to save him. Now suddenly Tix is in trouble. So Tix runs away, and Kiski Fish in the bush with the Mosh Pit instantly gets two. As it plays forward, though, we do see that Tix did not have enough damage, he didn't have mana, and he did not have ultimate. So he just ran away, but cooldown's traded, and again, Italy still in control. Finland just cannot find the opportunity, and that's the theme with this clip on the keep as well. So they try and bait the Punisher, and you can see all five of them are positioned aggressively. They're stacked on top of each other, but they just cannot get in. The Stukov silence against such value from Moldavius, completely poking Tyrael out. They get the keep, and as soon as they get the keep, they're out of it. They're done with this fight. They just massive shove away, and off they go. And I believe this might be the end of the game here. So if Finland tried to go behind, really good flank on the ETC, but was not enough. Arthas completely solos the Gul'dan in the backline with the help of the Punisher, gets the Ancestral, and from here it's just like Finland have run out of tools. Yeah. They've got no ultimates and they're desperately trying to run away. They're not successful. And there you go, that's game.
If that Gul'dan had stayed alive, that could have been completely different, because you got the beautiful Sank mosh pit on two people. If Gul'dan was able to drop a Corruption, maybe Italy would have been too low. Maybe they would have had to back up. Maybe Finland might have had the opportunity to try and counterattack. What happened is Gul'dan just got wrecked by Arthas.
Gul'dan got steamrolled by the Arthas.
Oh, so much. And as such, no damage. Mosh pit's dropped. And in the meantime, Punisher's still killing the Keep, and they're completely zoned out. They can't do anything.
Absolutely.
Really nicely done.
Yeah, it's complete control from Italy and a very frustrating series for Finland, where it just felt like things couldn't go their way.
Exactly. So Finland, they're going to find themselves in a pretty unfortunate spot now. But keep in mind, guys, that it's not over for the losers just yet. We have a round-robin system here, a single round-robin system in the group phase. So each team is going to face each other again, potentially, in a tiebreaker situation. So very cool to see that. Italy surprising a lot of people, casters and analysts included. I did not expect them to show up this strong, but we're not done for the day just yet. We're just getting started. So we're going to take a look at some of the upcoming best of threes. Italy, we can see them here once again showing up strong, but we have more in store, especially a team that I'm looking forward to seeing. Germany is going to play very, very soon against a team, Belgium, that, you know, in Group B looks pretty good. Belgium is a team that many consider to be a secret weapon, a dark horse.
Yeah, we know, once again, couple new names here, a couple familiar names. For example, Germany, we have Nunez, a little bit of a familiar name coming in straight away there. Whereas Belgium, we have Talouf, for example.
And I had Vabia, who are two Grandmaster level players. Again, people I run into quite often. I had Vabia specifically being known as a Veigar main. So we saw how powerful Veigar was in that series. Maybe that can continue on and he can get a lot of value.
But before we move on, guys, we're going to go on a short commercial break. Don't go anywhere, and we'll be back soon with Germany versus Belgium.